Hey, this is Ben from 20 Millimeters. In this episode, I want to show you some progress I made on the Stalingrad build, and I hope you like it. Finally, I had some time unboxing it completely, and since I heard from some friends that the MDF plates here suck up a lot of paint, I was looking for a solution how to give it a base coat. And I came up with the idea to use some regular wall paint, which was a leftover from other projects, and tried it out firstly on a small portion of the MDF cut where there were no parts on, and I was pretty surprised by the results and continued with it. After only a few minutes, you can already see that it's drying up fine. And not only covering good, but also giving a texture to the MDF board, which is also pretty cool since otherwise it's a pretty flat surface and doesn't look realistic. Since the test was very successful in my eyes, I continued and applied the color in larger scale and then left it drying overnight, and the results are really awesome. You still see all the details of the board and have a fully color covered surface which has a little bit of texture on it. It's very important that you choose the proper material for having it under your painted items, since otherwise you will have these leftovers of the paper which glue together with the color. In my case, it was not so bad since it looks like a little bit of ruins and gives it another layer of texture. I removed some of the other parts using a sharp knife. Now it was time to have a look into the manual and get the proper pieces out of the frames. For gluing them together, I used wood glue, the Ponal one I'm a lot of times using, and you need a sharp knife to cut sharp a little bit the edges matching into each other for a proper fitting. If you use the express wood glue like I did, you will see first the results very soon, and you can continue to glue the inner layers to the outer corpus. After that's done, it's time to connect the corpus to the base plate, and there you might want to use a screwdriver to enlarge the open spaces a little bit to have a proper fitting. Now it was time to start with the rear building, which has a lot of small parts, and you need to be really careful to not break the MDF since it's very thin at some places. After gluing them together, you get back a lot of stability, but still you need to be very careful. Do not break things. You can glue them, but it will be better to have it all in one piece. And the result looks great for the second part of the building. So I'm still missing out on some parts of the ruins and will have to continue painting it. But I called it a day after this step. I hope you liked my progress. Leave a thumbs up, and if not, you not have it already, leave also a subscription. See you in my next video.